everybody. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Online public test server. This is version 2.7.2. And I just wanted to mention that they recently came up with the date for release of the Homestead patch. That will be Monday, February 6th for PC and Mac, and Tuesday, February 21st for PlayStation, Xbox One. Now, today I just wanted to kind of go over some of the favorites that I have among all of the different types of housing. I will go through everything from the starter apartments up to the notable houses as to which one I enjoyed the most here on the PTS, and I'll tell you why. There are so many nice houses. There's different features that I kind of looked at. As far as, you know, can you hang, is it a place that you want to hang out for a little while and maybe do some tasks, do your crafting, hang out with some people, you know, things like that. And there are definitely some houses that I came across that I continued to go back to during my public testing to just get things done, or even to craft. I think just places that really impressed me enough to keep going back. So I'll go over those, and I will also show you how I decorated the starter apartments. I do have kind of my favorite in every single type of housing, but for the starter apartments, none of them come furnished. So I just kind of wanted to show you how I furnished all of those. And then I will start the favorites opinion section. So thank you for watching, and I'm looking forward to the test coming to an end and for this to go live. Okay, here are the apartments that I decorated. When you first get your starter apartment, they are not decorated and they do not have an option to purchase a decorated version, so you'll definitely need to purchase or craft your own furniture for these small apartments. So this is just a little slideshow to show what I came up with. For the Altmer apartment, I could not fit a bed in, so it became a small office, as you can see. All of these apartments do not have, they come with one candle, let's say they come with one candle, but they all required several sources of lights, so your biggest investment is going to be in the lights. I found that a couple of the wall sconces and a few candles placed throughout the room helped to bring in the light. They all have kind of an interesting atmosphere, kind of dark. Some better than others, but I was able to make something work. Also, there is a little limit to building around doors in any of these homes, so I had trouble placing rugs because the rooms were so small, but if you keep trying, you'll find one spot that the rug will fit. Anyway, this is just an example of what you could do with the small starter apartment. Okay, so for the small starter apartments, my favorite one is the ebony flask in room. I just like the style of the room when you come in the door. This beautiful window is right here. It takes well to the lighting, the number of candles that I had to place to bring in the light. As you can see, there are wall sconces and a mirror, but I did bring in a lot of light to the room, and it really shows off the window. The window is really just beautiful, so I was able to get quite a few things in here. This one is one of the ones for free, or it would cost 3,000 gold if you've already completed one in your own faction. So this one is located in Stone Falls, So it was Ebonheart Pact 1. And conveniently located right downtown Ebonheart. So you just walk right out and get into a tavern right away. Now, I still have problems with all of the seating. But this Red Guard couch I did manage to find actually is functional in the seating. The seating is still hit or miss in the whole patch. It doesn't matter whether it's purple, white category, or if you bought it in the crown store, if it came with the atmosphere outside in the world, I'm still having lots of trouble with the seating. This one did work out pretty well. So for the small apartments, I chose the Barbed Hook private room located in Aradon. It's available for 11,000 gold. And it's in Skywatch right here, so it's conveniently located to a city center. The reason why I like this room is basically it's the only one, I believe, that has a fireplace. So it already comes with fireplace. It's a decent size, and the windows are very pretty. I like the windows. Doesn't seem to take up too much in the way of lighting objects and to give it light. So with the fire and the way the windows are, it seems to be pretty light, and it seems to be a decent enough apartment. For the small homes, I chose Cyrodiilic Jungle House, located in the Bandari Trading Post in Malbaltor. The reason why I like this home is mainly for the yard. I think it's a good size yard for the small homes. There's plenty of space out here to do things, and if you wanted to invite people over, this would be a good place to hang out. It's one of the few homes that actually has a view of outside the walls, so it doesn't feel so claustrophobic. And there's plenty of space to put crafting stations, training dummies, so forth outside. The atmosphere is just beautiful. It's still got that aura of nature and weather. It's got a personality. Now, the only problem is that this is an Imperial home, so you need to have the Imperial Digital Edition to own it. And for the space outside is made up for by the lack of space inside. But for utilitarian purposes, the yard is the winner in this one. And you know, it's a decent size interior. There's certainly more. The other homes might have more space on the inside, but not as much atmosphere on the outside. And so for me personally, this is very nice. It's affordable. It's going to be 71,000 gold. So it's very likely that I will probably own this one when it goes live. So when you step outside of this house, you end up in the Bandari Trading Post. And even just standing out at the front is just a beautiful atmosphere. This is also one of my favorite places to go robbing and murdering. People laugh. So as you can see, it's very nicely located and it blends in well with the atmosphere. For the median home, I chose Mornolth Keep. This is located in Bankrai, right at the very top of the map. And right outside the door is the Halcyon Lake Way Shrine. 325,000 gold. So as far as the money goes, this is the best for both outdoor and indoor space. This has got a way shrine outside. It's got several locations outside with the kind of staging areas you could put. This is where I put my target skeleton out. I like to do target skeleton. Plenty of space to roam around. Also, it has a nice entrance at the bottom level, which I liked because it was just more convenient to come in and go straight to the house. Inside, there's plenty of room for sectioning out different uses. The previous patch, I put all my crafting stations in the basement here, and there was plenty of room for everything. Very nice atmosphere. There's a fireplace, stairs, and upstairs is quite simple, but it has plenty of room. It just seemed to be a very nice utilitarian location. Scenery. Upstairs, it has upstairs and a downstairs. It has another exit to the courtyard from the upstairs, which grants you this gorgeous view. Just a lot of deck space. So for a utilitarian house, for bringing over people and guests, you have quite a lot to offer with this house. So as you can see from the entrance of the house, there's a pathway that comes up. There's full view of Ankarai. Just over the hill here is the Way Shrine. It's a very nice location. Now for the large homes, I chose the Hunding's Palatial Hall in Strassum Kai. You probably could have guessed that this was going to be my favorite if you ever saw any of my previous videos. This house is just absolutely stunning. Just stunning for a large house. It is definitely one of the most expensive ones at 1,295,000 gold, but it is simply amazing. It is worth every single bit of gold for this house. Everything about it is just perfect. It's a gorgeous design, a gorgeous red guard design. So when you go inside, it has an amazing, one of the most amazing outdoor spaces. It has a beautiful home with lots of intricate details. The outside is just spacious, and you also get a beach, get a tower. Look at the tower. This is a must-have for any mage. You need a mage tower, don't you? It has a pool. At this point, I can't get in, but, you know, all you have to do is build a little stairs and you can get in. So you have the beach. You have this lovely view. Look at this. You cannot get to this island because of the slaughterfish, but you still... When you're looking out at the horizon on a beach, you want to look at something. And so, there's even a ship out there that could be your ship. So you have this wonderful beach. You do have sort of a small area where you could safely swim right here. And then you get sort of a dock. On the outside, you have even an upper deck that comes out. You can set chairs on or stand on to look at the views. And it's just gorgeous. I absolutely love this location. The location is right outside Strassum Kai. You get your own bridge. This is a complete island to yourself. Lots of space on the outside. Stables. Just a lot of personality to this house. This is definitely the best of the large homes. And then when you're coming in the house, you have a little courtyard here also to display things or have crafting stations, whatever you want. There's just, and up there, this balcony, you can get out on this balcony. I'll show you the balconies when I get inside. In the downstairs, you have a nice common area, several nooks to transform into whatever it is you want. In this case, they were able to put in a kitchen and kind of a bar-like seating. And then in the middle is open. You have a beautiful lantern up there, just gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. For the money, for this size of house and everything that it offers outside and as extra features, it is just stunning and definitely one of my favorites. Now, of course, I bought this with the 1 crown so I could have furnishings, which is good to show some of the concepts of how this could be decorated. Now out here you have these little porches, and I believe there's one on the other side as well. So you come out and you look at this porch, you can look across, you can see the other porch and a third porch over there, and all of them facing Strawsome Kai and the docks. Just absolutely spectacular. So you even have porches on the side, and these are nice sized porches. All of these decks, porches have a lot of space to add own furnishings. And as you can see, there's one that goes right out to that overlook. Just absolutely stunning. So here's the tower, and you can go right on in. I like that they've provided a functional structure that you can actually use. So you come up to the tower and you have even more stunning views. So for me, I would do definitely a mage's tower up here. So I'd be doing my enchanting and spells and keeps books and things. Okay, for notable homes, I chose Serenity Falls Estate, located in Reaper's March. This is just outside the little town of Shrinja. It is pretty close to the Shrinja Way Shrine. The entrance is over this little bridge and pond, and you have your very own Wisp Mother to yourself. So there's plenty of farming to do right outside the door. And when you approach, you're greeted with this beautiful staircase and doorway. Very nicely decorated. So when you first enter, you're greeted with the image of the mansion and the gatehouse. That's what you want to call this. I would call this a workhouse. So what you get, though, is the atmosphere outside. You get a waterfall. You get this water, this beautiful water in here, so you can actually go swimming. And a lot of space in this yard. So So with the two buildings, and this is a very nice sized building as well. So this is a great building to do all your crafting in. So there's plenty of space. Now, the yard is so massive that it seems like the house might be lacking in size, but for parties, for inviting your friends and guilds, this is going to be one spot that you're gonna really want. Costs 3,775,000 gold to own this. The waterfall and the pools, very relaxing. So I can foresee this to be just great for socializing, crafting, and doing everything that you might want to do with the homestead house. I like the design on the house, I like the gold trim. We also have an upper deck. Now the interior of the home is still is quite small considering the size of the lot. That is made up for by that other gatehouse, I believe. So in here you can have your basic home-like atmosphere. And you would save your gatehouse for the workshops and crafting and so forth. So I think that even though the interior of the house is kind of small for a palace, it makes up for it by having that extra utility building. And a typical small, there's like a really quite small deck. You wouldn't want to put chairs up here, but still get a view of the mountains. Okay, the last category is going to be the two Crown Store exclusive notable homes. And of course, I have no idea how much this is going to cost in the Crown Store, but I thought that I just wanted to go ahead and pick one of my favorites between the two, and in this case it is the Earth Tear Cavern located in Craglorn. It's right over here on the outskirts, probably through a lot of hostile territory. Much of Craglorn is pretty hostile. The reason why I like this is that there is so much detail. Now, I found a proper use for these ropes, finally. I figured I could put Tithus up there, which I've always been wanting to hang Tithus by his feet, because he's such a tricky little guy to get a hold of. Anyway, the detail in this cavern is amazing, and I think that it outdoes the tropical island in many ways because of the details. Because as far as you can see in the horizon, there is something to look at. And to me, that's really important, especially when you're going to spend a lot of crowns, I assume a lot of crowns, for this privilege of living in a special place like this. This has a lot of water, which I like. I like having water. But I've also seen people in the forums have created their own decks out of the materials available. So it doesn't have to be all water. But as you can see, when you look to the horizon, there's actually something to look at. Whereas on the island, when you look at the horizon, it's just water and sky, and there's nothing. Not even a ship or any other interesting thing to look at. So for me, the cavern wins. Plus, I've always wanted to live in a cavern here. I wonder why. So there's plenty of open space to hang out with friends. There are not one, but two waterfalls. I mean, it's just gorgeous. There's still so much that you can do to customize the zone. And even though it's in a cave, it doesn't feel claustrophobic. It's quite open. There's sunlight coming through. So it is very nice. And then you have up here, you're living in the ruins of something else. But there's enough room and atmosphere to build pretty much whatever you want. So look at the designs on the walls, so you get the sense of the ancient life that was here before you ever occupied the cave. I mean, it is definitely worth considering as a favorite. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching my video, and I'm pretty excited to see how this goes down in live. I'm very curious about the Crown Store prices for these homes furnished. And I guess for now, I'm going to have to go back to live and start making lots of gold. So I thank you for watching, and I hope you have a good day.